In this video, we're going to answer the question, what height do I need to mount sockets and switches in a domestic installation? This video relates to the rather lovely Perception CFX range of accessories from Hamilton. They can be used in conjunction with your wallpaper or paint to produce a seamless, very low visual impact installation where the switches and sockets blend into their surroundings. So if you haven't seen the video that Gordon and Gary made on that, please go and check it out. But to return to the question for this video, it's one of those that there's a clear answer to, but it comes with some provisos. What do we mean? Well, let's look at approved document M of the regs. So we're looking first of all at volume one of the approved document, which relates to dwellings. The document refers to three categories of property. These are category one, visitable dwellings, category two, accessible and adaptable dwellings, and category three, wheelchair user dwellings. The rules vary slightly depending on which of these categories the property you're working in is being built to. For category one, switches and sockets serving habitable rooms throughout the dwelling have their centre line 450 to 1200 mil above floor level. Category 2 dwellings should have switches and sockets with their centre line 450 to 1200 mil above floor level, with the additional requirement that they are also at least 300 millimetres horizontally from an inside corner. Category 3 dwellings change the rules even more and require that switches and sockets are mounted with their centre line 700 to 1000 millimetres above floor level and be no closer than 700 mil from an inside corner. But what about that situation where you're building an extension and the existing switches and sockets are not within these tolerances? Do you need to meet the requirements of Part M and have the potentially tricky situation of having an old and a new switch close to each other that are at different heights? Well, turning to paragraph 0.2 in the approved document, we read that the recommendations of this volume of this approved document apply to newly erected dwellings and dwellings undergoing material alteration only. They do not apply to the extension of a dwelling. So these requirements don't apply to extensions. However, there is that thought in that paragraph of a material alteration. In our context, a material alteration in the building regs means that you undertake work that makes a previously existing service non-compliant where it previously was compliant, or making a previously non-compliant service even less compliant. Most planning authorities will also stipulate that the extension must be no less compliant with Part M than the existing building. So while you may be able to match heights of switches and sockets that no longer comply, you couldn't put them in even worse positions. Of course, if the extension is significant or being built specifically for differently abled persons, then it will most likely need to comply with Part M. If in doubt about the category of property you're working on, or you're not sure if the extension you're working on needs to be Part M compliant, then contact the relevant planning office and they'll be able to clarify that for you. But as always, we want to hear from you. Do you always fit sockets and switches at Part M compliant heights, or do you prefer to match the existing accessories? Or do you take it on a case-by-case approach? Please leave your thoughts and questions in the comments below. And as always, thank you very much for watching.